If you can't take the heat, stay out the kitchen.
Yes.
That's what they say. That's what I've always heard. But I refuse to believe that. Why? Because I can teach you how to be fireproof.
Yes.
I'm going to tell you the three ways to bake the perfect cake. All right, you ready? The first way is preparation. You have to be prepared. Second is patience. And the third is personalization. Those are the three things you need, and every single cake you make will be perfect. Now, everyone heard of box cakes. We've all seen them in the store. They can be okay, but they are not as tasty as a homemade cake. Let's be honest. Homemade cakes are just better. They're healthier for you. They don't have as many preservatives. I love homemade cakes. I make them every chance I get. I love to make cupcakes. It's just a lot of fun. So, to be prepared in that preparation mode, you have to do three things. So we've had the first three. Now you have to preheat your oven, have to use the appropriate equipment, and then you also have to use the right ingredients. So your oven should be at 350 degrees when you go to bake your cake. The best way to preheat your oven is to start it while you're preparing your ingredients. The reason why is because if your oven is too hot, it's going to dry out, you're going to flame out, you've burned up, you're not fireproof anymore. You can't have a burnt up cake. If it's too low, your cake will take too long, it'll get soupy, it drops in the middle, that's not perfect. Again, you're not fireproof. 350 degrees, remember that, preheat your oven. The next thing is you have to have the appropriate equipment. Every cake has wet ingredients, dry ingredients. You can't mix your equipment up. You can't use the measuring spoons for your dry and your wet, because it'll mess up your ingredients. You don't want that. And then finally, room temperature. I know, we all think, okay, well, it uses eggs, it uses milk. Those things go in the refrigerator, because if they don't, they'll curdle. But you can't think that way for a cake, because if with a cake, when they're room temperature, they meld together better. And if you put cold ingredients into the oven, it'll actually curdle your cake. Okay? So don't use ingredients directly out of the oven. I mean, out of the refrigerator. Can't do that. Next, you have to have a little bit of patience. Don't get too anxious when it's time to bake your cake. When you do your dry ingredients, you have to measure properly. If you're like my husband, you just like to throw stuff in and say, no, it's going to come out great. That's not the case for the cake. You will not be fireproof if that happens. We want to make the perfect cake. You have to measure, measure, measure. Have a little bit of OCD when it comes to your ingredients. You take your flour, and when you get your flour, here's a little trick. You can't use your measuring cup to just get your flour out. It will pack your flour in and throw off your measurements, and your cake will come out a little bit dry. Use a separate measuring cup, anything you have, to then put your flour into your measuring cup and level it off. That way you'll have the appropriate amount and you won't have a dry cake. Trust me, it works. Next, you have to make sure that your wet ingredients are to the right level. Don't just pour it in and say, ah, it looks like it'll work. Can't do that. It won't work. It'll throw off your cake. Has to be the appropriate measurements. So remember that. Also, most cakes, when you make a homemade cake, it has to be you cream your butter and your sugar. Do that for at least 5 minutes. That's the perfect number. 5 minutes, because it gives it a lot of air in your cake and it makes it light and fluffy. Okay? And then your flour, you may see cake flour in the store. Don't even worry about it. Don't buy it. Don't need it. Use regular flour. But you cannot skip the sifting process. And don't get suckered into buying the expensive sifter out of Bed Bath & Beyond. You don't need it. You can take a regular strainer and use it as a sifter over your bowl. Little trick. Save some money. So that also will help your ingredients to combine better, and it will end up with a lighter, fluffier cake. The next thing that you have to do for your patience is use a timer. Use a timer. Because all cakes, if you cook them too long, we know, you're going to what? Burn out. The cake's going to be dry. Nobody's going to like it. Perfect cakes, use your timer. Don't open the oven until you're almost to the very end of your cake. If not, you're going to lose all your heat. Your cake is now going to sink. So you don't want to do that. Remember, use your timer. Don't open the oven until the timer goes off. Okay? And then finally, personalization. every cake deserves a personal touch. It's just, that's what makes it perfect. You can make a cake that is for a person and you tailor it to that person. Me personally, I love cookies and cream. Everything cookies and cream, I'm good. So take a little bit of Oreo, crush it up in a bag. You can sprinkle it on top of a cake that has some vanilla frosting. Boom, cookies and cream cake. It'll look cute. It's a little bit decoration. If your husband likes chocolate chips, throw some chocolate chips in the batter at the end. Bake it, chocolate chip cake.
There you go.
If your kids like Dora, throw a little pink frosting in it. Boom, pink cake. Perfect. So remember, when you're baking a cake, in order to stay fireproof and not burn out in the kitchen, you have to be prepared. You have to be patient, and you also have to personalize it. That way you will have the perfect cake. So with that, I'm gonna pass out a recipe book, card for a super moist cake that I use. Perfect, perfect, perfect. It will work for you every time. Trust me. Thank you.